You to give us about 30 minutes so we can have some sharing and activities together. Are you ready? Not ready? Okay, how many of you here attend the temple regularly. Can you please raise your hand? So that means you don't follow, you don't go with your parents to the temple often? You do? Okay, three of you. Who else? No? That's okay. I just ask. I don't either. Okay, today, first of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am a Buddhist monk named Pháp Hòa from Edmonton, Canada. Sometimes I have an opportunity to visit Southern California, especially visit all the Buddhist members in this area. And this time, they request me to take off some time to see all of you, just to say hello, to see how you guys doing, and if you have any question that you want to ask, you also can ask. You don't have to ask questions that related to Buddhism. Anything that you don't understand and you want to understand, maybe think you see your parents doing it, but you have no idea what they are doing. So you can ask, and I try my best to share. If you have nothing to ask, it's okay, then I will share with you briefly something according and related to our traditions. Okay? So we only ask you for about 30 minutes. The reason I invite you to sit around me because this is the practice that we like to have something like a family. We feel family together. And building a family is something very important in our daily practice. And please understand that when you have a chance to see the temple, or you go to the temple, or your parents go to the temple and they call themselves Buddhism, that means they do not, that doesn't mean that they are follow a religion. Okay? They just come there to learn a technique, a practice, so that they can apply in their daily life to make their life better. Buddhism is not a religion. Buddhism is an education to educate us to live more happy, to live more mindfully. That's it. For example, do you guys like to play games? We all like to play games. You have iPhone, you have iPad, and we like to play games. It's okay, but we also have something to study. We do have homework, right? So what would we do with Buddhist practice? We try to moderate the time that we play and the time we study. That's it. So the education to help us to learn the practicing of moderation, how to divide time to enjoy and time to study, time to work, how to adjust things to make things better. We used to have the habit of addiction. So when you stick into something, like you play game or you watch TV, you're unable to control your time. You're unable to control your time. And because of that, that's why sometimes you would yell by your parents, because you don't know how to control or manage your time. Is that happened to you sometime? Huh? Is that happened to you? Sometime or all the time? Look like all the time.
Never.
Oh, never. That's good for you. Okay. Do you have any question? Anything you want to know? Anything you want to ask? May I have one question first? Please.
Any question?
I'm a school teacher. Okay. And I see a lot of children. They pick butterflies, little ones, or ladybugs, or they catch it in a jar. Is that a good thing to do?
Of course, depends on maybe at according to their size. They're like, oh, this is the game that I like to play. Okay, but with your compassion, your loving kindness, you will try to choose some game that less violence. You choose some game that less suffer for others. It's fair. Let's say if someone come to you and they use a stick, they hit at them from your back, or they come to hit on your head, and they say, why you hit me? And they say, oh, just for fun. You wouldn't like that, right? Then same thing, like the butterflies or the ladybugs, they have their life the same as us. So there are tons of games. Why don't we try to take some game that less violence, less hurting others, less, you know, hurting your loving kindness, your compassion. In our United States country, we used to raise what do we call war peace. We always pray for the world peace. But if we live together between human and animals, between human and insects, and we have no loving kindness for them, it's a little kind of unfair. Okay? Anything you want, you don't want, try not to do to others. You get that idea? Okay? Anything we don't want, don't do to others. Let's say if somebody come to you, they use a scissor to cut a bundle of your hair, or they take some hair from your head. You hurt. You may punch them back. You say, why are you doing that to me? Oh, just for fun. See, it's not fair. So the Buddhist practice is we try to be fair. We try to be kindness to others. Do you see this? Sometimes you go to the shopping mall, somebody else go before you. What do? They open the doors for you. So you can come in. So while you come in, you say thank you, and you come to the next door, the next layer of door, you open the door, you let them come in. What is this? This is the kindest. And this is Buddhism. So you don't have to declare, I am Buddhism. But the way you live is already show that you are a Buddhist. You don't have to declare any kind of religion in you, because Buddhism is the way of life. Buddhism is the way to live peacefully, harmony, happily to each other. Is that explain something what we call Buddhism? Maybe you have heard the word Buddhism many times, but you are not very sure what is that. And today, I just want to share with you briefly the word Buddhism. We used to have the Buddha at home, at the temple, anywhere. So the statue there we call Buddha. Buddha is not God. Buddha is not a saint. Buddha is not a holy person. He's just a human like me and you. But in him, the very high compassionate was developed. In him, the very high understanding was developed. So he was the one who fully understand what's happening if you do something bad, what's happening if you do something good. So he just shared with us, he just showed us the way to practice. So that's why we respect the Buddha as our teacher, not a saint, not a god. So when you bow the Buddha, don't think you bow to a saint. Do not think that you bow to a god. You just bow because you pay your gratitude, the one who show us the way to live. And what is this way? Loving kindness, understanding. Do you receive love from your mom? Do you receive love from your dad? Sometimes you have done lots of wrong things, but people around you, they try to open their heart and accept you. Because they have understand that, first, maybe you still young. Secondly, maybe you don't understand why is that. Or maybe you have a very negative background. That's why you have turned into you know, a very negative person. So when you open your heart and try your best to understand someone, to embrace someone, you're already Buddhism. So Buddhism is a practice. Buddhism is not a religion. So the more you come, maybe at first you don't understand because we speak most Vietnamese. We speak for most Vietnamese. But remember, anything you don't know, you have the right to ask. The same as when you go to school. You don't understand your math problem, you stay back and you ask your teacher. Your teacher have the responsibility to show you how to make it, how to solve the problem. Why don't you ask? And because you don't ask, and we have no chance to share, that's why the distance between yourself and your own tradition start to depart. You have the root as a Vietnamese. You have the root as a Buddhism. And you are old enough now to go back to your source, to your root, and you know, and reverse, research who are you come from. You was born in the USA, United States, but you have the root of Vietnamese. Do you know how to eat nước mắm? Con biết ăn nước mắm không? Fish sauce. Con biết ăn fish sauce? Con biết ăn cơm không?
Yeah.
Rồi, that means you really Vietnamese. And if you may, you know what, Thầy, people used to address me as Thầy. Thầy means a teacher. Thầy means an elder brother in the practice. I always have feel happy that because I was born as a Vietnamese, but I live in Canada. The same as you. You was born in a Vietnamese family and you was raised up in United States. Then you have both traditions, cultural to learn. You know about your Vietnamese roots and you also know the American roots. We are so rich. So let's say if you meet a real American friend, they know nothing about Vietnamese. But if they want to know about you, they may research, right? So sometimes they know Vietnamese history more than you do. And this is a shame. Some American, they can eat nước mắm better than us. They can eat mắm tôm luôn. Mình không biết mắm tôm là gì. Okay? So I just want to remind you, okay, it is time for you now to go back to your roots and find about your roots. Looking for your root, because your grandparents, some of them pass away, some of them start to get old, and you guys growing up, that means your parents start to get older too. And once your parents no longer here, then you are totally, people will call you Vietnamese American, but you only have the name, but you don't have the quality of it. And we don't want that happen. Like, you want you to be study hard in school, you can speak English well, you can do something, but you proud that because you were born in an Asian tradition. Why? We have the right to be proud of what, who we are. You know, when I was in Canada, I ordained as a monk when I'm 15. So when I'm 7, I already have the commitment that when I grow up, I want to be a monk. So when I was 15, after I graduated from my grade 9, I told my parents that I want to be a monk. So they don't allow me, but I said, this is what I choose. So after that, they allow me to shave my head and become a monk. So I wear this robe to school, so people teasing me a lot. Teasing me all the time, everywhere I go to school. They're just teasing me, but I am not angry at all, to tell you the truth. You know why? Because they don't know about me. That's why they can teasing me. But I have to know who am I in order to be happy. So people can misunderstand you because they don't know about yourself. But if you are angry with that, that means you really not know who you are. So once you know who you are clearly, You don't care what people judge. You just be who you are. So you don't have the right to choose how you will be born, but you have the right to live as who you are. So never, ever, okay, refuse your root, yourself. Come to yourself, take your you as you are. Many people, when they watch me on YouTube, they think that I am a big guy. But when they meet me in person, they're disappointed. They say, Thai, you're too short. I'm not suffer at all. I'm short so I can save more fabrics. And they ask me, Thai, why you shave your head? To save shampoo. Why you become a monk? To save lot of money for jewelries and hairstyle. So when you become a monk, you save lot of money. I don't try to insist you become a monk, but if you want to, you able to. Okay? I just want to insist you don't refuse your roots. And you have to be happy. Look at this flower vase arranged. Okay? This is rose, this is lily. So each of these flowers, they have their own beauty. They have nothing to complain. And they can be together to make the nice arrangement. So you can mix with American, you can mix rice with spaghetti sauce. Instead of take a noodle, you can eat with bread, sandwich, whatever. I sometimes take spaghetti sauce with steamed vegetables instead of take noodles. I put all different kind of like broccoli, cauliflowers in a dish and I put the sauce in, I enjoy. Why not? You know the tea bag? Do you know tea bag? Tea come from China and Vietnam. So when England, they came to Asia, they learned how to make tea. They go back to the country, they develop and make as a tea bag. So they learn tea from us, but they create tea bag. So now we make jasmine or green tea bag, we copy their style. But the root, the tea is come from us. This is the same. When East Indian came to Vietnam, they show us how to make curry. But they don't use coconut milk. So now as a Vietnamese, we add more some coconut milk in and we become Vietnamese curry. So life is an art. You can create things to make things better, nicer, right? This is the mall, or you can turn into the medical clinic or whatever. But now we turn this into a center where we come here to practice. So things already there. Depends on how skillful you are. You can turn things into what you want. So you already Vietnamese. Then you can make yourself a richer Vietnamese. Vietnamese with Vietnamese cultural, Buddhism with Buddhism cultural, and now you have American cultural. So when you come to a Vietnamese, you can talk, you can explain. When you come to American, they don't know why you do that. You can tell them why is that. You can introduce your roots. Why not? If the more language you know, the better for your living. Is that true? Because language is for living. That's why in Vietnamese we call sinh ngữ. The more language you know, the better for your living. So this is not a Dhamma talk, this is not the lecturing or anything. I just want to see you, to say hello, and just remind. I came to America for many times, but very rarely that I meet the young people. And I always happy when I learn that lot of Vietnamese, when they grow up in this Western country, but they're very successful. And I'm so happy with that. And if any one of you who have some problem, you are unable to share to anyone, okay, find someone that you can share If not, you can write a letter, but never mistreat yourself. You have to treat yourself well, because this is show your understanding and your love. Okay, you have to love yourself, then you already show that you love your mom, because when you suffer yourself, the same time you suffer your mom, you suffer your dad. Because when they look at you and they realize you live in suffer, they suffer more than you. So you have lot of monks in this area, you have lot of nuns in this area. You can come to them, you can talk to them. They are there for you to talk. They are your spiritual teachers. So there's no way you just stay home, play games. Okay? It's okay, you have iPhone, you have iPad, now you have another eye, I pray. Do you know why we bow the Buddha three times? Why?
Tại vì Phật
Pháp Tăng. Ôi cha, giỏi quá. Thầy hỏi tiếng Anh mà trả lời tiếng Việt mới là siêu chứ. Con nói nữa đi. Thôi bây giờ con lên đây con ngồi. You can take my place. Cảm ơn thầy. Không, thầy này nè. Con tên gì?
Dạ con tên Lê Hữu Thiện Brandon.
Lê Hữu Thiện Brandon.
Pháp danh của con là Quảng Trí Tâm.
Quảng Trí Tâm. Oh. Thầy nghe con nói xong là thầy hands up. Giỏi quá. Cảm ơn thầy. Thầy Quảng Trí Tâm. Mai mốt con đi tu không? Kệ biết đi. I asked why we bow Buddha three times. Because when we bow, one bow for the Buddha, one bow for the teachings of the Buddha, and one bow for the community of the Buddhism. So the Buddha is our teacher. We call Buddha. Dharma is the teachings of the Buddha. So remember the term, huh? Buddha, Dharma, Sangha. Buddha is our teacher. Dharma is our teachings. Sangha is the community. That's why we bow three bows. Okay? So when you see, when you come to Buddhism, you see the statue of the Buddha, you know this is Buddha. You see all books, all scripture, we call Dharma. Or lecturing, or CD, or DVD. Do you see your mom and your dad or your grandparents watch Dharma talk on YouTube, online, sometimes at home? That they listening to the Dharma teachings. Even right now, you come here, sitting here with me, and I try to share with you briefly, this is Dharma too. So we are here like this for whole days. For today, yesterday, so this is the Sangha. Sangha means community. Can you repeat, please, three terms? Buddha, Dharma, Sangha. Okay? Buddha is the teacher, Dharma is the teachings, and Sangha is the community. Before you leave, we will sing a song. Very simple. Okay? I love Buddha. Yes, I do. Buddha is my teacher, teaching me to be free. I love Buddha, I love Buddha. Yes, I do, yes, I do. Buddha is my teacher, Buddha is my teacher, teaching me to be free. Simple. Okay, let's try one more time, louder please. I want to hear all the young voices, okay? I love Buddha, I love Buddha. Yes, I do, yes, I do. Buddha is my teacher, Buddha is my teacher, teaching me to be free. I love Dharma, I love Dharma. Yes, I do,
yes, I do.
Dharma is my teacher, Dharma is my teacher, teaching me to be free. I love Sangha, I love Sangha. Yes, I do, yes, I do. Sangha is my brother, Sangha is my sister, teaching me to be free. Thank you. So there are a lot of English articles that you can look in YouTube online to find more about Buddhism. I really invite you to take some of your time and learning something related to your root. First, as a Vietnamese, secondly, as a Buddhism. Because your parents now starting get older, your grandparents, some of them pass away, some of them very old. They unable to give you any other explanation because the English also very limited. So they really hope and wish. They put a lot of expectation, a lot of wishes of them on each of you. So I hope that you can see your role and be patient to learn and try to open your heart to learn more things. And one of the things that we try and should learn is our root. Any question? Mấy đứa lớn hỏi đi con. If you have question, con.
What makes a person successful?
What make a person successful? Is you guys hear the question? What make a person successful? And I think this is a good question. And this is the main question. This is a something important question, but not only for Thầy to answer. This can become something for all of you to reflect. Okay, I just share, I just give you some key according to my practice. Okay? You want to be successful? First of all, you have to accept and take who you are. You don't see your talent. You don't see your insight. You don't see your wisdom. You don't accept who you are. You don't accept your family. You don't accept your root. And that is the first thing you collapse because the foundation already collapsed. Things can be built after the foundation built. Any other levels can be built after the strong foundation built. And what is this foundation? Accepting who you are. Once you know who you are, how much you can do, your capacity, then you can start with that. For example, some people come to Thai and ask about political. And I will tell them the truth. This is not my job. I am not on this side. You can ask me about Buddhism. You can ask me about the teachings and the practice, but I'm not researching much about this. Though. So I cannot tell them this, but I will explore. I will wholeheartedly show and share and do what is my really talent, right? So each of you here, you have your own talent. The second thing, you want to be successful. And one of the key that you should keep in mind is your patience. If you want to be completely for something, you do not have enough patience, you are unable to make that become successful. For example, look at this flower arrangement. Look like very easy, right? Simple and easy, but not. First time you learn, you may not do as nice as this. But if you have no patience to learn about flower arrangement, you may refuse it, you may quit, and you cannot be a really flower arrangement. So be patient on anything you do. Even us, when we came to the United States or to Canada, we learn English. We have to be patient too. Because the way we pronounce, people may not understand. Or because of the grammar, because of the verbs, there are a lot of difficulties. But why we still can handle everything up to now? Because we have patience. Okay? So, of course, each of you, each of us here, we may have different experience about how to make our life successful. But according to my practice, first, know who you are. Never refuse you. Never mistreat you. Be honest and be happy with who you are. And try to work the best with your talent, with your goodness. And be patient when you do something, because none of the thing can be completely successful at the first time. Does that help you a little bit? Of course, is anyone here want to share more with what with the question here? Anyone who have experience? For yourself, okay? First thing for yourself. Always feel enough. Take things as you need. Do not take things as you want. Because the thing you need is limited. But the things you want are unlimited. And because you are on the way to come to the successful, so try to reduce your desire, but always learn to feel enough with what you have. Secondly, with others, be respectful. We always respect others. The third thing, to be patient. For yourself, less one thing. For others, be respect. For your job, your work, your study, be patient. Con hỏi không? Hỏi đi con.
I used to go to the lecture like this, and I sometimes listen to the lecture on YouTube, and I find out it's the lecture is very useful. And at that moment, I recognize that I can apply to my life. But when I go to work and we go to outside, I usually forget. So how could I remember those teachings? Mm.
The question is, this brother have watched a lot of lecturing on YouTube, but he tried to apply in his daily life, but sometimes he forgot. Is that question? And how can we remember to apply? Actually, you already practice, but you didn't see that you practice. If not, you are not happy up to this moment. Because Buddhism is very simple, it's come to us like our breath. It's not something major that you cannot touch. And you do not have to wait until you do something great in order to declare that I am Buddhism. Let's say, for one example, you are lining up to pay for your grocery. Somebody tried to squeeze in. At the first minute, the first moment, you're angry because, you know, this person is rude. But the second thought, you thought, oh, maybe he's in a rush. You can step one step backward. You know, a minute or a second you behind that person is not a big deal. But you may have done something great deal for that person because he was late for something and you are not in a rush. You already practice Buddhism, but maybe at that time, we don't know. We think we need to do something else in order to call Buddhism. You see what I mean by that? Lot of things that happen. Sometimes I fly back to Canada and I have to line up for custom. You know, I always try to rush so I can be online early. One day I was in a rush and I step in and there was a Canadian couple with their little kids. He looked at me like, why you have to do this? He didn't say anything, but the way he looked, already told me that he give me a lecture. I stand there and I feel uncomfortable. I wait so we can turn the line. I will step back and I know he have more kids. He need to go out first because it was late. I am single. I can go later. At that moment when I'm able to do that, I'm happy because I can see my faults. And I can step one step backward to let people before me. I am already practicing Buddhism, but I don't have to declare this is Buddhism. So you can see this in all of your daily life, but sometimes you didn't see it clearly. I just now share with you, you have practiced Buddhism in some way very gently, and that is good. You practice, but you don't have to show that you practice. And this is the real practice. Bên này hỏi không con? Như ngộ đạo hết rồi.
Có phụ huynh hỏi được không thầy?
Hả?
Có phụ huynh hỏi.
Rồi, phụ huynh hỏi.
Có phụ huynh lần sau muốn xin rồi. Lecture about respectful parents.
Short. Hình nhớ là hình như không có trả lương phần này nha. My young friends, this is sometimes will happen in our Vietnamese community. That's when sometimes you are not respectful enough for your parents or your grandparents, and this make them really hurt. Please understand, because your parents, your grandparents, they were born and raised up in a very traditional family. And one of the traditional custom of us is the young people must respect the elder people. This is something we cannot cut off. We cannot symbol. You know, in Vietnam, if you go to school, your teacher step into the class, all the students must stand up and pay respect to the teachers. When the teacher asks you a question, you cannot put your hand like this in order to answer that question, but you have to put your one hand like this and your elbow underneath like this. It shows that you mean you want to raise up by two hands, but you unable to, so you put another hand underneath to show you're respectful. You want to present something to someone, you must give by two hands. This is the way to show you're respectful. It's nice to know about this. If you go to some other countries, you learn, it's nice to know all the cultural, right? If you go to Korea, when you set up a table for food, for dinner, for lunch, if you set up spoon, you must turn the spoon up to let people know that you are welcoming your guests. So when you think, oh, no, because of the dust, I have to turn the spoon upside down so we don't have to, you know, to make the spoon clean. But the Korean people will say, oh, this is not respectful. This is the way to set up for the death, not for the living. So if you go to any other country, it's nice that you know their culture. So same thing. Don't, you know, try not to angry with your parents that they're so hard on you. They give you, you know, difficult times why they expect you too much. One thing that your parents, your grandparents ask about from us is be respectful. When you talk to them, sometimes we scream, Mom, phone! This is how you always happen in the family. Mom, phone! Somebody call in and say, Mẹ có nhà không con? Chờ một chút! And the person on the other line, they know you don't mean it. You don't mean to be disrespectful, but the way you speak to show that you are angry with their phone call. And then they increase their answer is, "Mom, phone." And they will know, oh, maybe they argument, but you are not like that. Just the way you speak make people misunderstanding. Because in the Vietnamese family, we never call mom like that. Mom, can you please pick up your car? Or mommy, you have a phone call. This is the complete way to tell. But you, it's a short, you can call your brother, Jason, pick up your phone. Or Jason, phone. You can speak like that to your brothers, your sisters, but not to your parents. We cannot say, oh, this is too hard. No, this is something for us to learn. When you first meet your girlfriend, you never talk like that to your girlfriend. If you do that to your girlfriend, you never have a girlfriend. Hello. Why can you call your friend? Hello, honey, what are you doing? We're so sweet to our loved one, but why we unable to sweet to our parents? And when your parents hear that, you're so sweet with your, on the other call, but when you turn to her, you were very salty. And they feel hurt. They feel hurt. Sometimes I know you don't mean it, but the way you talk make them hurt, but you never know. You ask your mom, can you stay home and look after my dog? You go to work, to your holiday, and you call back home and you never ask, mom, how are you? The first question is, mom, how was my dog? And your mom will, you know, she will think, so between a dog and me, who is more important? They are not hard, but this is, you should know the feelings. If somebody call you and they ask you the same question like that, you hurt the same. You hurt the same because people treat you lower than an animal. Even I know you guys love animals. But this is the way that we try to reflect a little bit back and try to learn how to live better. If you can change the way you treat, the way you talk, you're already Buddhism. Buddhism means when you're able to see your mistake, your wrong, you can adjust to make that much better. That's all. You can write a Valentine card for your loved one, but you never have anything for Mother's Day. Do you know what do we call your birthday? You call your birthday, right? Oh, this is my birthday. Today is my birthday. Next week is my birthday. But in our tradition, your birthday is we have another name. The Mother's Heart Day. Instead of calling your birthday, there is another name to call that day. Mother's Heart Day. Because she is deliver you as a baby, it's very hard. It's not very easy for her. She have to handle a lot of painful. It's really her heart day. So in our tradition, if it is your birthday, you can receive lots of gifts from others, but yourself, you have to prepare a gift for your mom because you have to thanks to her who brought you to life. This is the tradition. So I don't mean to push you, but I introduce you. What is the beautiful of the traditions? When we talk about spaghetti and pizza, do you know where they come from? Italy, right? When we talk about cơm tấm, bì xương chả, you know this is a Vietnamese dish. So even the food, when they talk about the food, you know where is this root. Then why not we have our own root? Con hiểu không? Được rồi ha. Hết giờ mà cũng hết lương. Okay, thank you guys. Thank you for your coming. Thank you for your listening. And I know maybe you are not taking my words now, but if you're able to have some space for Thai, that is my pleasure. Okay? I hope that my words and today's meeting have come some your heart, your mind have some corner for this sharing today, and you can take it home and reflect, and I will be happy. And if you're able to take some of this into your daily life, and that will be my pleasure. Thank you so much for your listening, for your time. This is the question. Dear Thai, I have a daughter, she is 6 years old, and she wants to ask you why you have no hair. I already answered to save shampoo. Do you spend a lot of time for your hair? At least 10 minutes a day, right? To comb your hair, to wash your hair, to dry your hair. I don't need conditioner. I only need shampoo. And I don't have to spend a lot of time every morning to combing my hair. And I also don't have to look at some magazine to see what is the hairstyle for this this month. So I save money for hairstyle magazine. Because hair symbolizes for afflictions, something you know, if you still have something, you have to take care of that part. So as a monk, we try to symbol our life as much as you can. And hairstyle is one of the things that make you very busy. So try to save your time to do something more easy. Instead of busy, we try to live easy. That's why we like easy off. My friends, there are some of the young friends who were taking the ceremony after this. So because we don't want to move out and make more noise and take more time, that we are unable to settle the hall back. So give me another 5 minutes to explain this. There is a ceremony we call taking refuge ceremony, that you're willing to take the Buddha, the Dharma, the Sangha, as I just mentioned, as something for you to take refuge in. Take refuge in the Buddha, take refuge in the Dharma, take refuge in the Sangha. Buddha, Dharma, Sangha. Why you have to take this ceremony? In order to inform that you are now a Buddhist. You are now the students of the Buddha. So you try to live your life meaningful and mindful. A couple, when they love each other, good enough. Why they have to get married? So they get married, the wedding ceremony to inform them, now you are the one who marry. You are the husband, you are the wife. You have to have the responsibility to live your life as a couple meaningful. Of course, when they love each other, they live together, it's good enough. But why they need ceremony? The ceremony to inform their responsibility. Same thing. Today, when you take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha, you are informed as the Buddhist. You have the responsibility to live your life meaningful. What is this meaningful practice? Not to kill, to nurture your loving kindness. Not to steal, to be fair. Anything that not belong to you, you won't take. Same thing. If you lose something, you suffer. Then we try to understand others. If they lose something, they suffer the same. So because of the fair on this society, we try not to take anything that not belong to us. So once we get married, we should keep our happiness our family by not getting any other sexual misconduct. Another word, you cannot get and engage with anyone who is not your spouse. Because if you're doing that, you break the happiness of your family. You break the happiness of others' families. The fourth thing we practice, daily conversation. Try to use loving speech. Words can make people happy. Words can make people suffering. So as a Buddhist, as a Buddha, the students of the Buddha, we try to say something to make others happy. We try to say something to suffer less for others. And this is our daily practice, a mindful conversation on our daily communication. And the last one, I think, is also important. Remember that you have a very healthy body. You have a young age. You have a lot of energy of living. Try not to damage your future, your life, by drugs, alcohols. Another word, try to be mindful on things that you intake into your body. Because if you're not mindful enough to what you take, you may damage your physical body. And once your physical body is damaged, you're unable to do anything to help others. Because even yourself, you cannot help. Because now you are sick. So be mindful on your daily consumption. Drugs, alcohol, toxins, those will kill your body. And once your body is damaged, your mind also related. The internet is very useful. But if you are not aware what kind of website that you should visit, some of the website totally waste time, nothing to learn, but damage you more. Some of the movies just increase your violence, but never give you any learning. So as the first question I share, if any games you play that increase your violence, this is not a healthy game. Any books that you read increase your violence, your passion, your evils, and this is not a healthy books to read, not a healthy movie or novels to contact. So try to come in touch with something that make you feel better. Try to intake what make your physical body healthier. Do not make your health reduce, but we try to increase. Why we take vitamins? Why we take immune pills? Because we want to boost up what is missing in our body. Same thing. Try not to make your physical and your mentally health become ill because of your daily food or because of your daily in touch. These are the five things I want to share. When you pass by the Buddhist temple, you see there is the flag with five colors. Oh, maybe right in front. When you pass by the gate, you see the five colors there. That five colors symbolize for the five trainings I just shared with you. Killing, stealing, sexual misconduct, lying, and mistreat to your body and mind by daily consumption. Those are the five trainings that I share. That five also symbolize for the five continents. Can you imagine if the five continents follow this five instruction to live, we have the world of peace. You don't have to be a Buddhist in order to take this. As a human, we all need this. All the things I share, nothing related to religions. They are related to our daily life. It was the human's life manner. It was our manner. We have to take and practice it. Thank you. Hi, guys. Từ con, please massage your legs and you can stand up.